K-pop became very popular because of the influx of Asian novellas first, and then it was the telenovela of Rain, who was also a K-pop star, who paved the way for people to discover that there were K-pop artists like TVXQ, Domachi, and all the other K-pop artists, but it was mostly online. So when they found out that Wayne was a pop star, they knew about all the other pop stars that were with him. So everything just skyrocketed after that. Internet is a tool that is free, first of all, because the fans are students, they're kids, so they don't have much funds about it. But the thing that really made it significant is its crowdsourcing abilities. Like, the fans were able to provide their fan arts, their info about their favorite idols. The idols themselves were able to communicate to their fans in a very personal level because of online. So it was really significant in that way. It wasn't really more about information dissemination. It was really experience distribution to a wide variety of audiences, especially here in the Philippines. It's not a fad anymore because I'm not sure how you would define a fad if it's something that it just stays for 10 years, 5 years, 3 years, 2 years. But it's been more than 5 years here. So if we're going to work on it very, very well, and if we're going to be careful about the things that we're going to say about it or do about it, then I believe it can be a whole new genre on its own, especially now that it's already infiltrating the global scene and not just the Philippines or Korea itself. So we have collaborations already with the mainstream acts, like them doing Gangnam Style, Wonder Girls having the producers of Jonas Brothers. It's all there. So if we're going to do things right, I believe K-pop is going to be genre. Well, the thing about K-pop is it's a 360 approach, which most mainstream acts just found out about it now. So with K-pop, you have the merchandise, you have the CDs, you have everything else. And the fans want to live with those things. It's not just like with Western people, like they have a crush on Justin Bieber, that's why they buy his picture or his album, they want to see the pictures. With K-pop, it's because they want to support their idol, they want them to eat, they want them to like make a living out of themselves, they want them to have more money so that they can go to other countries. It's that personal. It's not like it's just they idolize them. It's more of like their family, some of them want to get married with those K-pop idols. It's really personal. That's why it's really different from Western music, which is a wide variety of artists with so many different genres. But with K-pop, they're all Korean, they're all pop, and they all have an edge that apparently captures so many people in one way. It's a united way that is respected by all those who also love K-pop in a different manner. Well, right now, Filipinos are doing the same thing. But the thing is, they're always available. Like, you see them on TV on a noontime show. You see them on Mix. You see them here every day, like in the mall or something like that. They're not really that scarce. And like for K-pop, like Korean artists, they're in Korea. They have different looks every time. That's why kids have, oh, I want the blue jacket of like this, or I want the new album like this, because it's really scarce. It's not available readily. And like with the Filipino artists, like for example, Glock9 released a shirt. But then again, the next day, you'll see his shirt in Green Hills or another mall where Glock9's not selling it. So it's really easy to produce. Like with K-pop, like their merch are really hard to mock. It's really hard to duplicate here, so I guess as long as the quality is there and it's really hard to replicate with all the piracy and everything, the Filipino artists, if we won't learn to make our craft at par with the global scene, well, music, we have succeeded because in iTunes, like, so many local artists are already doing good, like Rico Blanco was number one. There's this band called Techie Romantics and Taken by Cars who's taking Singapore by storm. There are also like the likes of Trace Bimbenco, Arnel Pineda was already doing good in music. But in terms of merch, albums, we still have a lot to learn, and hopefully some pick up what the K-pop industry is doing with music.